Gewoest way.
Yeah,
is
yeah.
It Captain Blast?
Yes, it's on.
Today I must be quick.
Yeah, yeah. As you said on that stalker video.
Now I always say that I will be quick, viewers, but that means that this will be at least again. No, I mean today I will cut when I'm talking.
What?
This will be again.
What will you do?
In the video, because
you will
tell
cut
the truth, hey.
You will cut when you talk. That.
Yeah, yeah.
What's this, hey?
To tell you the truth, viewers, we don't know how to make a short video on this channel, and even that is not even the point, because all the friends that we have. 26,400 friends, I mean by
the
this
best
time.
Best subscribers ever.
Best subscribers in the world, best friends. And by this time, I mean we are filming for 4 years, and by now you already know that on this channel we can't make a short video because we're always discussing something. Captain Dash, wait there. Don't come too quick, because there is still something that I have to say.
I usually don't come too quick.
Nobody, salute yours,
hey.
Friends, welcome.
I usually don't come so quick.
Yeah, of course, but on this channel always. I mean, okay. I mean, just look at the essay. Again, we have the brown box with the FMS writing on. And I will tell you right now that this is the plane that I have wanted from the moment that it was released. I have never clicked. I was waiting for such a long time that at the end I have almost missed it. But it is here. And now I will start to discuss. I must say a few words really quick, because I must say a few words.
Where did this came from? From Belgium, I think, France.
Oh, yeah, really.
What's written?
I don't know. Yeah, it doesn't say nothing here. Aha! No. It must be, I think, from Germany or something.
Germany.
I have found this bird in Germany again.
Salute, Daniel Nadi, quick.
Daniel, our friend and brother, Erse, brother, I hope to see you this year again here on our runway, and we will have some fun together, but I was trying to say something. Now, all the men always say that the size doesn't matter.
Well, it does.
I will start like this, but deep inside, we all know that is not true.
Well.
Now don't worry, viewers, because this is the RC plane channel. I'm talking about RC planes when I'm saying that. But at this time we have learned that the bigger is better.
Yes.
On this channel we have learned about planes. Now there are things in your life that you can't control, and you must be satisfied with what you have. But if you must work with what God gave you. But if you order yourself the RC plane, you have a choice there, and you can click on the bigger one.
What? Is this why you have such a big planes? Because there is something very small.
I don't have the complex here, eh? Because many guys have the complex, and then you buy yourself a Ferrari, a Porsche, I don't know what. And you're missing something.
Oh, it's
else.
Okay, because I drive a Citroen, so.
Yeah, we drive rusty cars, so hey, who cares? But of course, viewers, of course, we are joking here, and we might joke on this channel a little, because flying RC planes and filming RC planes, for us, this is not a life and death situation. We're not filming for the money, we're not filming to get free planes, but we enjoy this so much, and we want to share that with you, and we joke a little from time to time. But I will tell you just this. Now lately I have got many questions.
What?
When will you test the new E-Flight Mustang 1.5 meter? Will you test that on your channel? Viewers, of course we will. If the E-Flight, the Horizon Hobby, will send us one, we will be glad to film it and tell you what we think about that. But I come back to that point. If you can choose in your life a bigger plane, well, the bigger planes, they look more beautiful on the runway. Usually they do
yes,
fly better.
As
than
this, look.
That is giant.
Look at this color, say. Green is my favorite, as you all know.
Usually they do fly better. Of course, they also crash harder because they're bigger. But of course, every time you go fly, you try to keep your plane in one piece. So that's it. Now, and we come back to the point of this, a beautiful question, what do we have today? Now, this will be a buddy, a companion of my already in the hangar, beautiful, sexy and amazing FMS Giant 1.7 meter Corsair.
Yes.
And this is not the Corsair, but the beautiful and sexy FMS Giant 1.7 meter P-51
correct
Mustang, and I wanted to see this.
Hey, correct me if I'm wrong, but don't you also have 1.7 meter Bolso from Hangar 9?
Of course, I also have the brand new assembled, never in the air, still waiting for the maiden Corsair from the Hangar 9, 1.7 meter. But I also have the brand new FMS that you don't even know, the 1.7 meter Tiger Cat. But that will be for some different story and not for today. Now I will just cut the handles here, just do this.
Oh, this one, you have this one.
Yeah, and can you imagine? Hey, watch your nuts, but what's with you? Even the cardboard can ruin your nuts.
Oh my god, I think.
And then you will not scream in the bedroom anymore, but you will.
What did you say?
You will scream here, eh? Now just quickly remove the cardboard. Wait. Oh, this is big, eh? Now I will turn it to you, and this, the memory comes back. This is like a deja vu, deja vu, because in fact, the plane that we have unboxed already on this
came channel, in the same box.
It came in the same box. They have the same box for all the planes.
And you even said on that video that you know for one of these.
On that video, I have said that I hope that someday I will also have this one. And today I will say I hope that someday I will have even this one. Eh? But this one is really hard to find. But I think that I have found one in some store, I must just remember where I have put it myself, the link to that, and now, of course.
Well, how can you find anything on your own computer when you have 100,000 links on that bookmark?
But we are saying, let's have fun while we can. I mean, the time will come when we will stop filming, eh? But for now, eh, it's okay. Now, I will turn it to you. So, in fact, you can see.
Wait,
here,
specs.
Yeah, show the specifications so I don't have to tell the viewers later.
No,
I
mean, this is not the real one.
Yeah, it is not.
No.
Aha, this is the Corsair.
Ah, this is, yes.
Aha, these are the specs for the Mustang. Look at the SA.
Around 4,000 grams.
And it runs on 6L, and can you imagine this? Now, of course, you can see here. Show this quick. We can also show this quickly. We will be quick. These versions that you have. You have the one version of P-47, a blue version of Corsair, but you have two versions of Mustangs. Now, I didn't find this one, but hey. The it's red okay. will be as good as the yellow one.
Quite a ferocious Frankie.
Ferocious Frankie, and this one is what? Red tail.
Yes, red tail.
This one is red tail, of course. I will put this back from the camera away. And now, help me, Captain Blush, we will slowly take out the cover. And now be prepared.
It has broken.
Hey.
It has broken here.
Wait, give the viewers a moment so they can be impressed.
Look how old this is. Look at the duct tape. It's
yeah, of
all
course
yellow.
It is. This is not some brand new stuff on the market, but you can still find them. Are you ready?
So much fuss for nothing, eh?
We were preparing so much, viewers.
Hey, hello.
And there is cardboard again here.
Water destroying.
Oh, quick. I screwed that plate sheet, eh? It fell down.
No, it's okay. It's just.
We can leave it like this because later I will.
No, you can see.
No, yeah, wait.
You see it first.
Of course. Hey, yeah. I will be the first one to see it, eh? Hey, dear Lord. Because I have got one
can
question.
Can I open it?
Yeah. Show this beauty to the world. I mean, look at this and be impressed at this moment, eh? Do you see this?
Ooh.
Now, of course, I will put this away. This will be later for the closure of the video. I mean, viewers, Christmas time all over again on Patricius Brothers channel. Let's put this here on this, like this. And now I will start piece by piece. Just remember, Captain Bosch, how it was packed. Because later I will put it back, and this will be the flying project for me for the spring. When the surgery will be behind me.
And another one, hello. Another one. Oh yeah, okay.
And my hand will work again. Now one guy said that if we could pay for this, quick. FMS, the instruction manual, you will say.
Yes.
The Holy Bible of every plane, don't lose their time, because that is the most important thing on the plane. And I save every single one from the first plane that I have bought. I have the foils and every manual.
Yes, for one truck already.
Are you ready to see the beautiful sexy wing for the first time, eh? Now let's be thorough, because I got one question, if we could really take a closer look. So one guy is now considering to buy this giant version or maybe the E-Flight one. Now I will tell you, I mean, I know I haven't tried the E-Flight Mustang, but I can tell you that I know that that plane is okay. But this is the bigger version. So let's see how it's made.
Oh, look at this cover. Just look, sequence doors.
Yeah, of course, look.
Look, servo here. Another one. Look at the wheel.
Because this has the sequence door, the doors open, then the wheels came out, and then the door closes. Hey, that's interesting. It doesn't stay open when you're
look at this.
Fiddling on the grass.
Look
of course, look. Already all prepared, connected, and all you have to do inside.
I think that the plane has this.
Yeah, the plane has this connector inside.
Salute FMS.
Hey, even for such an old plane,
you just plug it in and that's
for
it.
You. Because you know how mind-blowing is if you have to put all this together in the plane every time that you put the wings in. And with this connector, it just clicks, eh?
Oh, do you know what I see?
What?
I see a metal gears in here, eh?
Yeah, I think that, of course, this one has the metal gear servos inside. Servos already pre-installed. The bird is painted, not just some phony baloney stickers
on. Bombs?
And, of course, look at this. A beautiful sexy navigational lights, and the wheels are really big. Because I must say one thing, Captain Mark. Now we have tested on this channel by now the FMS 1.45 meter wingspan Mustang, the gunfighter, and I will tell you that that one, even in that size, was the most grass, the best grass handling warbird that I have tested from a foam until now on this channel. And can you imagine if that one has handled the grass runway so well, I can't even believe how this one will. Because, hey, like we have said, the size matters. Eh? Even the coverage is for the wheels, and that's it. Eh? You have beautiful flaps, they're not split flaps, but hey, they will do the work. Eh? Because to tell you the truth, I don't know. If on the real one, I didn't check, they were like this, or maybe they were some split, or I don't know. But at the
end, split flaps, split flips.
Split flips, yeah. Because at the end, who cares about that? Eh? As long as we have this plane here.
As long as we have chips.
And
fish.
We will test it and we will have fun with it. And I will have it in my hangar. Now, take this and look at this. Eh?
Oh, look at this quality.
Look how beautifully it is painted. And I
look
can
at the hinges,
see.
Eh?
What?
Look how it's made. What is this?
I don't know.
Splitting, okay. Look, you see
beautiful
this?
Paint job. I mean, no coincidences, viewers, and I can see already that this is bolt together construction. Do you see this? Eh?
Yes.
No gluing involved here. Of course, I will have to screw the control horns. But these are just the foam hinges.
No, I was looking at that. What's this? What's this purpose for? Is this on a real plane also?
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe this helps.
Maybe something. This is the main hinge in the real plane.
It helps. No, it helps for the.
It helps
for the wind, so it helps the servo or something like that.
Yes. Now, this?
Oh, I just wonder now one thing, okay? Do you see this? I wonder one thing. I mean, this is old. I wonder how. Because the box was cracked here, eh?
What?
Do you see this? Should this be like it is, eh?
This is exactly in the middle.
Well, it looks to me.
Yes.
Well, it is.
Yeah, maybe this
so
is.
This is supposed to be like this.
Yeah, you can look
does
at the manual.
V shape?
Yes, of course. Look.
Maybe is it does?
Yeah. It is V shaped. Look.
Oh. Oh, so this is okay. Hey, I just thought that somebody kicked on
this
and bent it.
Oh, look at this.
Of course, some even more scale detail. What is this? Stickers. So it will really look.
Look.
Yeah, of course it is.
It's bad.
Oh, and thanks to God for that. Because I was really worried. I mean, it wouldn't be hard to straighten this, but hey. Good thing that I didn't. Because then
hey,
this
hello.
Person would
oh.
see the escalator.
Oi.
What? Oh.
The boom.
Of course. No.
Fuel tanks?
These are the fuel tanks.
Auxiliary fuel tanks.
And I think, oh yeah, baby. They just pop inside the plane. Look yeah. at this. You can have them on the plane or you don't have them. You don't have to glue them. I think that you have to glue here first. The
yeah, yeah.
the housing for that. And then later you just pop in the fuel tank. If you like that the plane will
just like you
scale.
Pop, just
of
like you pop in your pants.
I mean, stuff like this, they do create a little extra drag, but I don't think that it's so much that you would put it away and say yourself that you have spared 50% of the battery just because you have popped this out. I don't think that that's true. Eh? Now, of course,
carbon bar.
Another carbon bar. I just wonder for what this is. Do you have two holes in the wings?
Yes.
Oh.
The carbon goes here.
Yeah.
And the aluminum here. Goes in the back.
And the bigger one here, of course, because I was thinking this is for the back, but you can see here that it doesn't need this one. We can take out. Oh, look at this.
Oh, yes.
Look at this sexy pillow.
Give it to me. I'll show to the viewers.
Okay. Oh. You can already see here
bolt construction.
The bolt construction is the here the bolts. Oh, of course.
Yes.
Look at this.
Two at also, the front, one at the back.
One at the back. That's it. Huh?
You know?
Pretty good, mate.
It's really tough.
Yeah, of course it is. I mean, EPO foam, but really tough, viewers. Not just some silly, phony baloney EPO foam, mate. They just say that it's EPO, but in fact it's. The EPS or something like that.
Extremely poor shit, as we said.
Yeah. Of course, the second wing, exactly like the first one, eh?
Yeah,
mirror image of the first wing, so we can go next, so we won't be too long. Oh. But this was, Captain Blush, remember this. This was in the front on the motor side. Uh-huh. Because I still have a little more. Oh, look at this, eh? A little more at the back. Uh-huh. I can already see here, look at this. All the screws needed to assemble this plane.
Countersink.
Oh, look at this, eh?
Ho. What?
Look. The exhausts.
Yeah.
That you glue on the, the fuselage later.
For extra sexiness.
Those were not all the bolts, because you still have them here. Do you see this? Beautiful and sexy antenna that you glue in. Under the wing, so you secure the wing. Oh. The screws for the wings, and big one, look at this. Eh?
What is
not some small that you have.
This is M6.
Pretty big, huh? I mean, like they should be for this.
Ah, yeah, all everything inside. The control,
and
extra control horn for servers.
Oh, for the servers. I will check if they're inside or not, maybe. All that you need, the hardware is there. Of course, here you have also, look at this, eh? The machine guns for the tips of the wings, do you see?
Look how sexy.
Look over here, look at this, eh?
Very sexy.
But this is, viewers, I will tell you this, I mean, hey, I don't mind to glue the plane if it is not too much of gluing and if the gluing is simple. And to glue this on this plane, some machine guns, the
foam tack is a miracle glue.
Yeah, I'm using foam tack now on everything.
What am I missing? The propeller?
No, you're not, because at this moment, eh? Now look at the size of this.
Hey, what size is this?
Look at the size. But who cares? But it's big, eh? I can tell you that it is pretty big.
Is this four-bladed?
The Captain Blood.
Look at
this, eh?
It bolts into here.
Look! The beautiful and sexy four blades.
Don't you even have spare ones?
Not, because this is the 1.7 meter one. Or maybe
the
Corsair
has the same one, I think.
Yeah! Wait, stand still, because at this point I will salute myself.
No, me.
Because when I have ordered the Corsair, I have ordered the four spare props.
No, they will not fit.
They will not?
They are made. There are the ones that the Corsair are rounded, and these are some strange shape.
Show me quick.
Yeah, look at this. You see? Those ones are rounded.
Oh, yeah, this will not fit. I will unsalute myself for this because I don't have to spare props for this plane. Of course, I will try to find them when they're still selling them. I will find them somewhere. But hey, if I will be careful and I know that this plane won't be there 1,000 times.
So you said it will be fast. It's already over 20 minutes.
Oh, so must be quick. Uh-huh, of course, look at this. I have found it, the housings for the fuel tanks. Do you see this?
Oh, yeah.
You just do this in, tuck, tuck, pop them in, and that's it. And now we will come to the best part of every unboxing, and that is we will take it out. So, yes, see, I mean, viewers, the plane I'm talking about. The fuselage of this big, oh, look how big it is. The big beast. Oh, look at this.
Oh.
I don't think that 1.5 meter one is the same size, eh?
No, I don't think so.
Hey,
what's this? Hey, wait. What's this? Look, where does this have a hatch, eh? Oh. Hey, turn it around. To you.
Wait, Captain Blush. First, come here. I will grab it.
I am here.
Look, the size of this.
Miss Kentucky State.
And look at this, eh? And here. Look at this beautiful, sexy, look, the stickers, look how sexy and scale it looks. Oh, they're already all glued here on the plane.
Yeah, but hey.
But hey, one thing, Captain, show the cockpit. When have you seen a so scale cockpit on the foam plane? I don't think so, eh?
No.
Look at this side, show from this side. Instrumental panels even on the side. Do you see this, eh?
Look at this, eh? But what's this? Turn it around. Turn it to you, no, please.
What?
What's this?
Yeah, open it.
Oh, it's a servo. It operates from the servo. I will not do it on force now. When I have turned that, it had moved the servo inside.
Now you can see here that even the tail wheel has the sequence door. Do you see this? It closes totally. Don't open nothing else, Captain Blush, because you can't put it
there. No. Don't force it.
What have you done now?
Hey.
But what this here say?
You must try it, huh?
And did I do this or you?
Yeah, but don't force it like you do it like this.
Yeah, but what this is?
Yeah, I don't know.
I didn't know that this existed on the real one. What does this mean? That the air comes from here or what?
I don't know.
I don't think that this plane was having paratroopers inside, eh?
It's so
small. Look at this, of course you can see here, look at this, beautiful, sexy. Leave that alone, eh?
I'm all nervous now, eh?
Because you don't know what that means, eh? But hey, the size of this, I mean, hey. Now I will open it like this so we can see what's inside. Oh, look at this big hatch.
What? Salute.
Salute?
XT90.
Why? Of course, I can see
the XT90. Yeah. You have those connectors on the big batteries,
because
don't
I
you?
I have the 6S batteries that have these connectors. And I think that even this baby will fly on what? That 3300.
Look, here is where the wings.
Yeah, here you connect the wings.
On this.
You have the connectors prepared. You just get the cables from here and that's it. Now here you have.
Here's the servo. Wait, I'll close the doors.
Oh, like this, eh?
Yes.
But I must really check out what this means. Why do you open this?
Extra cooling, maybe?
Maybe you open this and I don't know. I mean, I think that even the real one has this. But let's take a closer look inside. I mean,
wait, I'll come there.
Sexy servos. Mm-hmm. And this is some small servo, do you see this? Much smaller than the other.
It just opens the doors, that's it.
It just opens the doors a little.
Look, what's this? Look, some programming card. What's this?
It must be some sequencer for the
doors.
But I didn't know that this has the XT90. Hey, I mean, this is sick, eh?
Did they used to have EC5?
Hey. Oh, I don't know, eh?
Or that red connectors?
Because I think that on the big Corsair, it wasn't the XT90.
No, it was not.
I don't know. So this is the position of the battery, or what? You put it here. This is the position of the battery, the Velcros. You even have, look at this.
What?
But why are this here? You see how interesting, I didn't see that before. What's this? What does this mean for the cables or what?
What?
Get this! Why do you have the Velcro here and this? What does this hold?
You will see in the manual.
Now, I think that you must stuck the battery somewhere. I don't think that this will be the position. Maybe it must go inside somewhere. Hey. Hey. Oh, it fits perfect. Did you see that, eh?
Yes.
But the cockpit, I mean, this is amazing, eh? I didn't saw a cockpit like this before in my life, eh?
No.
Now I'll just put it here a little. Uh-huh. What does it say? What's that? I don't know, Captain Blood.
Even I don't know. Let's CG. Is CG it? Is 120 millimeters from the inner leading edge in the plane.
What does it say about... What does it say about... The battery, how big?
The battery?
I'll just check on the side when I have bought this.
Doesn't say anything.
No, I think that it must be some information inside.
Uh-huh, number 7 is what? Yeah, it's labeled, but it doesn't say what it is. Number 7. What are you doing?
I'm struggling here. Like this, to have put it a little together. So we will have a little idea of how big this plane will be.
But you put it okay, it's okay like this.
I'll just put it like this.
Yes.
Hey, good enough, eh? I will of course put a little tail. A little tail.
Yeah, well, half an hour.
Yeah, but this is sick, eh? I just can't make it short.
Yeah, I know,
look
eh?
Look at this.
And my
look,
hands are going to fall out.
Impress me, quick, Captain Blasher. Do you see this, eh?
Oh, look at this. What is this? What does it say?
360 kV. Yes.
Hey, I can't wait to assemble this. I mean, you will say, once it will be assembled, hey, it will look 100,000 times better, but hey, for now, hey,
I mean, if maybe someone knows what is that hatch at the back,
you can, of course it will know, you
make
will
a comment.
I mean, even I will maybe check after this, I will go on the internet and see the real Mustangs, what was going on with that, hey? Because I'm really curious about that one. So this is it, Captain Bosch?
Yes, it's about time, yes.
Yeah, it's about time.
Because we have another unboxing to do.
I will have to grab it like this. Eh? So this is it, what to tell at the end? Well, hey, I can tell that I'm really happy that I have bought this one, that it will be in my hangar. It will be a great companion to my beautiful and sexy 1.7 meter FMS Corsair. And I can tell you right now that this plane is worth its money. Because I will tell you this, that in fact, this plane, the joint 1.7 meter FMS P-51 Mustang has costed me exactly $50 less than the E-Flight 1.5 meter Mustang, okay?
There's
so
not,
this is it.
There's
it's not, up to you to choose, eh?
Yeah.
But like we have said, hey, the bigger is better, hey.
That's it.
And this will handle the grass runway much more easier because the wheels are big, hey. So this is it.
Yes.
Pilot Robert and Captain Blas signing off from Slovenia with beautiful and sexy giant FMS 1.7 meter one P-51 Mustang that runs on 6 cell and it will give us another great maiden flight video and more fun on this channel. And that's it. Now Captain Blas could beep! Because we must do what?
Another unboxing.
Yeah, another unboxing, pretty quick. And that one will be quicker. Viewers, of course, thanks for stopping by, for all your comments, for your subscriptions, for any thumb up, and for being our friends. You're always welcome to visit us here in Slovenia. Don't forget, Slovenia is small, but we have it all. Eh? And if you will come here, you will love our country even more than us. Eh? But of course, we're living in the most beautiful country, in we're the most beautiful.
Yeah, the battery is ending, another unboxing, yeah.
Yeah, so quick, cut, yeah. Captain Blas, what will you do?